Hi there, Mike here. This video is an updated dual boot guide for installing Bazzite alongside of Windows 11. Here are a few notes before we get started. Back up anything important, as things can and do go wrong when installing operating systems. You'll need about 64 gigs or more free space on your SSD drive. Don't try and install Bazzite on a mechanical hard drive. The experience is bad. If you have a very old machine, I'm talking 10 plus years old, Bazzite may not work for you, as Bazzite only comes pre-installed with the latest graphics card drivers. A physical wired keyboard is required. Get a flash drive of at least 16 gigs in size, and make sure that it uses USB 3.0 or higher. Also, make sure that you have about an hour or so to do the installation. We'll be performing the following together. We'll pick the right Bazzite ISO file using the wizard on the website. Then we'll create a bootable USB drive with Ventoy and copy over our ISO files. Next, we'll check that our ISO files are valid by checking the checksums. Next, we'll disable Windows' fast startup feature. We'll disable Secure Boot. Then we're off to install Bazzite. Next up, we enroll the Bazzite Secure Boot key in the mock config screen. Finally, we'll turn Secure Boot back on again. And lastly, we'll double check that both Bazzite and Windows 11 are both booting. Let's get the Bazzite ISO. We navigate to bazzite.gg. We select Download Bazzite. Bazzite will ask you a few questions to determine which ISO you want to install. What hardware are you using? I'm going to select Desktop. You pick your device type. Who is the vendor of your primary GPU? Take note that there are two options for NVIDIA. And there are two options for Intel GPUs. Don't pick the wrong one. What desktop environment do you prefer? KDE is nice if you like the look and feel of Windows 10. And it's also what SteamOS uses as their desktop environment. I usually use GNOME for my NVIDIA installs as it's more stable for me and it works well on a touch screen. I'm going to select GNOME now because KDE doesn't want to work in my VM today for some reason. Do you want Steam Game Mode? Select Yes if you want something similar to SteamOS, otherwise select No. I'm installing to a VM, so I'll select No. Note that Steam Gaming Mode is not available for NVIDIA and Intel legacy GPUs. Now select the download option. I'm going to download the ISO using Free Download Manager, and I'm going to also download the checksum file. Our downloads are complete. Now we need a tool to boot the ISO. I usually use Ventoy as it allows you to copy multiple ISO images to your USB flash drive. However, if you have problems with Ventoy, the Bazzite documentation also recommends Fedora Media Writer or Rufus as alternatives. Note that anything on the USB flash drive will be lost when the drive is formatted. Let's download Ventoy from SourceForge. Let's give it a moment to download. Now we just extract Ventoy. And the file that we want to run is ventoy2disk.exe. Open Options, select Partition Style, and select GPT. This stops the drive from being bootable using legacy CSM, which saves us from potential trouble further down the line. Now, insert your USB flash drive. Select it and click on Install. Gives us a warning that all the data will be lost. Yes, continue. And it double checks. Yes. Now we can just copy over whatever ISO files we want to the USB drive. I'm going to copy over our Bazzite GNOME ISO, and I'm also going to copy over Linux Mint. Note that I'm also copying over the checksum files, and we'll get to that in the next step. I like to perform a checksum on the ISO media. I'm going to use 7-Zip for this, which you can download and install from the 7-Zip homepage. I like to perform the checksum after I've copied the ISO files onto my bootable Ventoy USB. That way I know that what I'm about to install is byte for byte what the Bazzite maintainers uploaded to the website. So if I right click on the Bazzite GNOME ISO file, go to 7-Zip, go to CRC SHA and click on SHA-256. This will do the checksum, and then I can take the checksum file that I downloaded from the Bazzite site and open that in Notepad. Now when the checksum has finished calculating, if we compare the checksum that was calculated by 7-Zip and we compare it with the one that we downloaded from the website, we can see that they are identical. Next, we're going to turn off fast startup and hibernate while we're at it. Fast startup makes your machine go into a semi-hibernate state when you shut down Windows. It makes Windows boot about 5 seconds faster. It also often causes problems when you're trying to dual boot, so we're going to turn it off. Open up Control Panel. Click on Hardware and Sound. Click on Change what the power buttons do. Click on Change settings that are currently unavailable. Untick Turn on Fast Startup. And we're going to untick Hibernate and save changes. Now let's make some space for our Bazzite install. Generally, it would be best to install Bazzite to its own disk entirely. But in this scenario, we don't have another disk. Right-click on the Windows menu. Select Disk Management, and here I'm going to assume that your Windows installed to your C drive. Right click, shrink volume, give it a moment to query the amount of free space available, and we're going to give Windows about 20 gigs of free space, and we'll leave the rest free for Bazzite. Now I've restarted and I've entered the BIOS. Every device has a different way in which you enter the BIOS. For example, my ROG Ally, you press the volume button to get into the BIOS. My HP laptop, you have to mash escape at boot. Have a look online to see how you enter the BIOS in your device. I'm going to just turn off secure boot. That's also in a different place in every BIOS. It's usually somewhere in advanced settings. Have a look online to find out where you disable yours. Okay, I've turned off secure boot. If you see an entry for fast boot, turn that off as well. Now after rebooting again, secure boot is now disabled, and we're going to select our boot manager. We're going to select Bazzite, and we're going to go for normal mode. And we don't need to test the media because we've already tested the media and we've confirmed that the checksums match. So we're just going to select Install Bazzite. And we wait for the installer screen to show up. As you can see, it takes a little while and sometimes you do get some random errors. Now let's install Bazzite. Let's just continue. You just select the right drive. And we want to select Advanced Custom. Click on Done. We're not going to do the automatic configuration. Otherwise, we'll end up with a shared EFI partition with Windows. All right. Click on the free space. Click on Add. And we are going to make change it to MIB 300. Change the file system to EFI system partition, call it Bazzite EFI, and we're going to make the mount point slash boot slash EFI. Click on OK. If you do anything wrong, you can undo the last action, or you can reset all and start again from scratch if you like. Let's carry on with the install. We're going to make a boot partition. So we're going to leave it on GIB, change it to 1 gig, leave the file system as extension 4, change the label to bazzite-boot. The labels aren't necessary, but I just find it easier to read when I'm looking at the partitions later on. Mount.boot. Next, we're going to make another partition. This one, we're just going to leave it to use the rest of the free space. We're going to change the file system to btrfs and leave the mount point blank. Now we need to configure our btrfs volumes. So we're just going to click in the left-hand side here. Click on the plus button. And our first volume, we're going to call it root and mount point slash. Next, we're going to make a mount point for var. So name var, mount point slash var. Next, we'll make a home, call it home, mount point slash var slash home. Click on OK. Now we should be done with the disk configuration side. So just click on done. Click on accept changes. Now we're not done just yet. If we don't click on user creation, you'll end up with a user called Bazzite with the password Bazzite. We don't want that, so I'm going to make my own user. And that's it. Nothing else has an exclamation mark on it. We're good to begin the installation. Just a note before I click on install. Up to this point in time, nothing has actually changed on the disk. So if there is something that you've forgotten to back up, this is the point of no return. We're going to click on begin installation. All right, the installation is complete. Let's click on reboot system. Now we're going to get a blue screen. With secure boot, only kernel modules with valid signatures are allowed. So on this screen, we're going to enroll our Bazzite kernel key. We'll go and select the enroll mock option, continue, say yes. And for the password, we're going to enter in universalblue. Now, you won't see anything while you're typing. This is fully expected. When you press enter, if the key is accepted, you will just have the option to reboot. If the key is denied, you'll have as many attempts to re-enter it as needed. Click on reboot to continue. Open up the BIOS again. And we're going to enable secure boot. Otherwise, you probably won't be able to boot into Windows again. And let's just reset the machine. And we're going to just confirm that Bazzite loads. Cool. And we get to the login screen of Bazzite. And we logged in successfully. Let's do the same test for Windows. In Windows, if you get a prompt telling you to enter in your BitLocker recovery key, you can Google instructions for that. You generally won't get that prompt unless you try and boot Windows while secure boot is off. I didn't get that in this scenario. And we logged into Windows and everything looks good. Here I need to do a small amendment to the original video. I didn't cover how to get back into Windows. I've received multiple comments about this and I apologize for the oversight. There are four ways that I know of that you can get back into Windows. My favorite way is adding a shortcut to Steam using a terminal command. We open up the terminal and we type ugest setup boot Windows Steam, press enter. When it asks for your password, type in the password, press enter. And now when you switch to Steam, you have a shortcut to boot Windows. If you want more information on this, have a look at the full video on it, which I have displayed in the corner here. we can add Windows to the grub menu, open the terminal, and run ujust regenerate-grub. You're hoping to see the output that it's found Windows Boot Manager. Next up, we run ujust configure grub, and we want to select the second option so that grub is always shown when there are multiple operating systems to boot. And then you can just select the Windows Boot Manager option from the grub menu when you start up the machine. If you're running Bazzite on a handheld, you can open up Handheld Daemon, jump into its settings, go to General, and select the option to boot into Windows. You can, of course, use the BIOS boot menu and select the operating system that you want on startup. And remember that you can change the default booting operating system in your BIOS settings. Of course, every BIOS is different, so you'll need to look online for how to do that. So we have a successful dual boot installation. Thanks for watching. I hope that this guide was helpful. Have a lovely day. Goodbye.